further conversations with some of the topics that came up here at other convenings that are already planned or will happen. So thank you so much, everyone, for openness and for the candor and the really, really refreshing conversation.
It's Mark and I were talking. It's been a really great mix of local Los Angeles folks and our visitors from international and national. And the conversation has felt casual, which is great, but very honest. And there's been a depth to the conversation that I think we really appreciate. I spoke to a few people earlier this morning so that we would have some anchors to respond to the last couple of days. And this is, again, very casual from where you're sitting. Just sharing some thoughts about the last 2 days with each other, conversations you might have had. So why don't we just start with that? And as I mentioned to you, I had asked a couple of folks, please begin, and then give the rest of you a little more time to think about things. Not anyone, of course, needs to respond, and they can be very brief, but why don't you start? Well, I'm going to have Matt start, actually. I am going to pick somebody. Sure.
Okay. Our last talk about the back and forth. So I think that really, on very concrete levels, there are a lot of things to share. That's one thing. Apart from that, I had those wonderful inspirational talks of the artist. I was really grateful for that, because it was both talking about mirrors, shattering mirrors, the essence of art as a spiritual experience, to how you could relate fiction and reality. I mean, there were, but it's it is a proof of how strong the choice of the artistic program is, because well, I've made new idols. I've met some idols from before, and I was very happy to restore our friendships. And, well, yeah, thank you so much for having us here and for making us experience this, and I hope you all get once the opportunity to come and see ITM in its functioning as a network. We have our two meetings a year, to look at our websites to see whether or not you would be able to once visit those meetings and share your experiences with us. Have a urinary in their bathroom. It's, and they had 90. present our views on how the neighborhoods can be developed. And this has been a forum for that inspiration and to grow those cojones.
Washington, D.C.,
And I come here and I'm like, well, did I just come and gentrify in someone else's city who is doing the same thing in my city? So, you know, I wrestle with that. And then as an artist, I think, yes, the artists are already in these communities. So let's give these artists who are already in these communities places and opportunity to exhibit their art, right? But then again, you know, me working with the funders, okay, how do we get people to support this? How do we make it not necessarily sound sexy, but how do we justify what we're doing? And I think this symposium for these past 2 days, I'm not quite sure if I've gotten any answers, but again, the questions, at least for me, are rising up. And my questions that I'm leaving with are, how can I join the conversation, but how can I come to the table as an artist, as a person who works in arts administration, and as sort of a citizen of Los Angeles and of the world, as a global citizen? All right, now we've got all these sort of questions and we heard all these people talking. Next step, how do we make it happen? So that's my thoughts.
Thank you. They're not trained performers. How do they inhabit whatever the hell it is that they're doing? doing and saying, as with that fullness, they wrote those words. They're all in the program. It doesn't tell us what they mean in English, but somehow their stories come to us via our stories and who we are. And that's true propriety. It's true propriety where I can hand over something that means something to me and leave room in it for you to fill in the blanks with the who you are. And I guess that's what's coming to me so profoundly so far these past few days, and I've only seen, what, four plays of that. But again, with gratitude.
This ritual, you know, with TBA of going in and out together as groups and community, and that you know, as Crystal was just saying, this theater, we're in a theater experience right now, you know, and this cannot be. It's always made very clear to me that we must do this as community, as those who make our art together. You know, if we were dentists, we'd be going to conferences all the time, very regularly, you know. So, you know, we need to be doing this as professionals in our field and to continue to, you know, see our mates and respect each other and the work that we're doing, and to stand in awe of the work that we're making, the beautiful work that you've made possible for us to see in this bottleneck experience that we're having. And I just want to kind of champagne-like explode on the other end of it. You know, what's going to happen for all of us is going to be very exciting to track and see, and is another reason why we need to stay doing this on a regular basis. So I want to thank you. I also want to let people know that if you like this, come to the Fury Factory in July in San Francisco. You know, so there is, and you know, go on up to Portland and keep going. You know, the West Coast is identifying ourselves now, and I feel this very strongly. So I want to give thanks and say hi to me if you haven't met me yet.
Hi, everyone. Malcolm Darrell with the Festival's Associate Producers. Thank you all for coming. It's been such an honor to meet so many of you and to interesting, particularly with Lemmy's work, is this idea that the community can be professional, can wow us as professionals. And the question I leave for all of us is, how do we not become a clique? Mm-hmm. And how do we, for Radar L.A. 2015, 2017, under the radar, hyper, how do we begin to incorporate our community into these conversations so it's not the cool kids gathered to look at our cool work and talk about these amazing things, but that we are truly integrating our communities. So is that mean that every festival we require that we bring someone along from the community who has never attended a theater festival? Because if these conversations stay insular, we're doing ourselves and our communities in this world a disservice. So I want us to really remind ourselves, and I'm very proud of the work that we've done, but there's always work to continue to do. And I believe particularly with us as artists, we have to fight against being a clique.
Yay!
Thank you, everybody. You didn't have to say nice things. You could have also complained. Or complained to the thank you for engaging with each other. Thank you for, especially to people who took part in one of the panels. And thank you to LATC, Jose Luis, for having us here. And of course, there's extra work already. We use it at each theater for performances to add these conversations as extra effort, so really appreciate it. But this building, of course, is owned and operated, well, owned by the, well, operated by the Latino Theater Company, Jose Luis is the artistic director, but owned by the City of Los Angeles and Olga Garay, the Department of Cultural Affairs. Thank you for working together with them during the of course, for your first and ongoing important support of Radar LA, every aspect of it. Other major funders of Radar LA, the Doris Duke Charitable Foundation was sort of the first to step up and commit to support it, and specifically to help make possible this symposium aspect of the discussion that we're having. Thank you. Other funders include Art Place America, the National Endowment for the Arts, and vital project support from the National Performance Network, especially their Performing Americas program, looking at FK and Elizabeth, and also for two projects in particular from the New England Foundation for the Arts, the National Dance Project of NEFA, and also the National Theater Project. Thank you. Dina Selnau,